I want to talk to you today about provenance, or history. This is really important for any kind of art, and here's why. The provenance is the history that goes with that piece. Now, that can be vital to the price, to knowing if it's real, and a whole slew of issues as far as when you go to sell it in the future. Does this really belong to this piece? And what's the history? You have a history that's very important and shows great ownership or very early piece can make a huge difference in price. But here's the caveat. Provenance can also very easily be changed, be faked even, and I'm just going to give you some of the types of provenance that you should look for in a piece that some are better than others. And of course, we always look for these things. The first one would be visual. Now, this is probably as good as any. That really means photographic. You have a piece, you see it in an early museum, it's that piece. We know when the photograph was taken, we assume the photograph is real, you can tell it's an old photograph. So anytime you can see it in somebody's home, they bring in old family photos of it, something that shows that there was a visual image, or it was in an exhibit if it's a painting, and you can see the painting in a 1912 exhibit. This is great provenance. This is real solid provenance. Then you have oral histories, oral provenance. Now, this can be all over the place, and this is one of those ones that really you have to be careful of. And I'll give you just a quick example. Somebody brought me in a bracelet the other day. They said they caught it in the 1970s. It looked like it could have been a 70s bracelet. It was a nice bracelet. I didn't really care if it was 70s, 60s, 80s, or 90s, but the fact of it is they said it was 70s. I took them at their word. I did a little research on the bracelet, and all of a sudden I realized, oh, well, this silversmith's not active until like the 1990s to the 2000 time frame. So clearly, even that short little provenance time frame of family history got screwed up somehow. And I don't think they were trying to pull something over me. That's just what they had. And this is not atypical. So you want to make sure, if you have an oral history, that it matches the piece. And I've seen lots of oral histories over the years of, oh, this was owned by Geronimo, or this was Sitting Bull's. You know, those just don't occur. But they could if they have some kind of the next, which is written history. So you have the oral. Now, written history would be something that was done early on. And hopefully it was notarized, but something that the paper's old, it's dated from that time of when the piece was supposed to be made or collected. The earlier the provenance written down that's original from the original owner or artist, the better. Again, all things can be fake, this could be too, but this is much more important than if you have something like it's a family history that they wrote it 10 years ago or 5 years ago. Those things are still basically back to oral history. The earlier the writing, the more solid it is that you can really feel comfortable, then that's a real piece of provenance. Otherwise, maybe not so much. Also, if you can get a letter of authenticity from either from the artist or the art gallery, that also helps. And old receipts, those are fantastic as long as they match up to the piece. And sometimes they'll have a good enough description, you can do it. A lot of times you'll see it came with a piece, it makes sense. The person brought it in and said, yeah, my grandmother got it. Here's your old receipt, 1930, here's it is. And you just can tell and you realize, yeah, this is right. It's the writing's right, goes with the piece. There's no reason for these people to be telling you a story. So those are the kind of things you want to investigate before you buy any piece. If they have history, is it real? Also things like ribbons and things like that. Ribbons are great, but they can also get mixed up. And I've seen it a lot of times, old ribbons that are mixed up and matched with other things. Sometimes you can go to those early records if you're really interested, try to find out if that was the piece, who the judges were. They're often on the back of the ribbon. So do some research. So the bottom line is, just because it has a provenance doesn't mean it's real or affects the value unless it is one of those three kinds. And the better the provenance, visual being the best, the more likely you are to have something of real value.
Listen to the Art Dealer Diaries. That's my new podcast. And, you know, I interview all sorts of interesting people that come through my life, whether it's an art dealer or a collector or an artist. Somebody that I find interesting, and I think you will too. So listen to the Art Dealer Diaries. You can find it on YouTube and on any podcast forum.
Brought to you by Medicine Man Gallery, located for over 26 years in Tucson, Arizona, specializing in antique Native American art, early Western art, including the famed Maynard Dixon, as well as modern art. You can find everything online at medicinemangallery.com. There's over 6,000 objects to select from. Also, the Charles Bloom Murder Mystery Series, written by yours truly, me, Mark Sublett. There's 6 books in the series, and they follow the protagonist Charles Bloom through all the intrigue of the art world set in Santa Fe and the Navajo Nation. These can be found on Audible, eBooks, Amazon, and of course, the gallery at medicinemangallery.com.